Good evening. This is Morris Joseph Bresnahan, travel vlogger and world explorer. So, in this video, I want to talk about a story that a friend told me. He was an ex-31st degree Freemason, the real deal. Not a firefighter who goes out to drink on the weekends, although that's fine as well. I mean, there are different levels to Freemasonry, and I don't want to reveal too much because I don't want to get killed. But at the same time, these are all true stories he told me. Now, this guy is based in Vienne, and he had been to Antarctica at least three separate occasions, and now he currently works at the Vienna Museum of Natural History. His main course of study is Egyptology, but he had been on, like I said, I believe it was two or three various expeditions to Antarctica to explore supposedly hidden caverns that were there. Now, when I had heard a little bit about this before in the past, but I hadn't really looked into the subject. But basically what he told me was that there's like an entrance in Antarctica and there's another entrance in Tibet, and surrounding it are perfectly shaped pyramids. And what island are these pyramids on? Rothschild Island. That's all I'll say about that. But anyway, he told me that this entryway was like pretty easy to access, but the strangest thing he saw when going down in here was there were all these different vials, like all these vials and shelves, and each vial contained like a different kind of bacteria. And he had told me of a story where he had witnessed a Russian scientist. Now, I don't know if this is true. This is all him telling stories he told me. So it may or may not be true, but I would definitely trust this guy because he was an ex-Freemason and he's a scientist. So let's carry on. But going back to the Russian scientist, the Russian scientist drank one of these vials and he told me that he turned all blue and just died. Like he just froze to death suddenly. And you don't know why, but some of the vials were taken back, I believe either to Moscow or Vienna at the time. And again, this was several years ago. He said this was back in around like 2007-ish, 2008-ish, which is also interesting because the first Transformers movie, I believe, came out in 2007. And there's like the whole scene with like Megatron and the ice and the whole scene in Antarctica. Now, people way, way, way at the top know all about this stuff. They know, like, the most elite of the elite know about all this stuff under Antarctica. And in fact, hint at it several times. And in order to get the public ready for, I'll let you know in the future, but he believes that there is a whole civilization of monks who master chi beneath the ground. Now, as crazy as this sounds, this has been like an ongoing, persisting theory since like, I don't know, hundreds and hundreds of years. Like Jules Verne even wrote, like Jules Verne hinted at in Journey to the Center of the Earth, like the whole story around that was about like the hollow earth theory. In World War II, you had scientists from Russia, Germany, USA all trying to get down there for some reason. I mean, it wasn't really disclosed at the time, but as time goes on, we learn more and more. So, he told me that he brought back several vials of the strange liquid and strange bacteria. They were all on shelves, and he even mentioned like bizarre, like trap doors, like almost Indiana Jones style. I know it sounds hard to believe, but this is just what he told me. And he told me that he gave a monkey one of the diarrhea, and it was screaming at first. Sorry, he gave the monkey one of the vials and had explosive diarrhea. This monkey, like at first, he started screaming, but then he just started shitting everywhere and having diarrhea to the point where he just died of dehydration. Which I think is messed up. I don't think we should test on animals. But again, this is all part of the story he's telling me. So, the strangest thing, now he never mentioned seeing any live humans beneath the ground. It's possible that they may all be dead at this point. But there's definitely evidence that there was some kind of subterranean civilization beneath the surface. And there may in fact be, because these vials, he said, looked fresh. Like, these weren't old, like, decaying vials. Like, it kind of reminded me of that guy who went on that raft tour to Disney World who, went to Discovery Island and found all the, pickled snakes, but those had been there for, like, years. Besides, it's like, that's unusual, but not as unusual as this. So, the bacteria he found, it was just fresh bacteria, different, like, vials of different liquids and stuff. But the weirdest thing that stood out to me the most was he mentioned a 50-foot skeleton statue with wearing gold armor and holding like a reptilian-like skull, which may or may not have something to do with the Anunnaki. Now, this, in my opinion, would make sense that it was some kind of Anunnaki colony historically, because the Anunnaki had landed not just in Mesopotamia, but also Peru and Malta. There's been evidence found of Homo capensis skulls. But he said this wasn't a Homo capensis, which is like the gray-headed alien skull. And again, Indiana Jones' Kingdom of the Crystal Skull mentions this, which is, again, kind of like a ritual to prepare people for the future. But he said the skeleton was just holding out the skull and he didn't dare touch it because who knows what kind of Indiana Jones shit could happen. But I guess to sum it all up is, I believe what this guy says because he was a very credible individual. Let me know in the comment section what you think. Do you think Hollywood, and do you think that like the government hints at these things so it can get the public ready? Because like, there's been a lot of talk about UFOs recently, and considering all the insanity going on around the world, it's like, it's not too far-fetched as time goes on. It's like, we believe certain ideas because we've been conditioned to believe it, and if you're told something that goes completely against everything you've been taught to believe, it's like, of course you're going to resist it, and this is a natural, healthy response. Because we're told to be wary of certain, and again, this age of information, disinformation, so you don't know what to discern what is reality and what is fiction. So what I suggest to you is use your own judgment and let me know in the comment section, could there be life out there, and could there be in fact a civilization beneath the surface in Antarctica that some may know about, but the majority don't. But in the future, we may all find out. Done!